When people want to learn a new skill, practicing components of the skill tends to lead to better acquisition of the skill. There are several different ways that a person can practice a skill, and one of these is by utilizing contextual interference. Contextual interference results from changing the task or skills being practiced from trial to trial. The more frequently the task is changed, the higher the contextual interference. A way of practicing with contextual interference is blocking the trials, which results in very little contextual interference. An example of this block practice is learning how to play basketball, with the person practicing all the bounce pass trials first, then moving on to the overhead pass trials, then moving on to the chest pass trials. This practice is blocked as the person does not move on to another skill until the trial for one skill is completed. Another type of practice is random practice, which has high contextual interference. Unlike block practice, which is structured and rigid, random practice involves switching between trials. Using the same example as before, a person would practice a bounce pass trial, then move on to another trial, which could be a bounce, chest, or overhead pass. Initially, high contextual interference results in poor performance. However, it does produce better learning retention than low contextual interference in the long term. There are three main hypotheses that suggest why this happens. The first is the elaborative processing hypothesis, which suggests that people that use random practice engage in more elaborative and distinctive conceptual processing. This is through people comparing, contrasting to the different skills as they practice. The second hypothesis is the action plan reconstruction hypothesis, which argues that people have to reconstruct learning of each skill as each trial is not the same as the preceding trial. The third hypothesis is the error processing hypothesis, which implies that the learning from random practice schedules can be due to the feedback that is given when a person fails on a skill trial. There has been support for all three hypotheses, which suggests that each could be contributing to the underlying cause for why contextual interference improves learning retention.
Can we take advantage of contextual interference? So now that you know what contextual interference is, let's learn how you can take advantage of it. Contextual interference can be a useful learning mechanism when used correctly in practice. Contextual interference, as stated previously, is the learning benefit you get from using a random practice schedule rather than a blocked practice schedule. And this was highlighted by Broadbent and colleagues in 2017. Contextual interference is advantageous for many key reasons. Random practice leads to less context dependency, in which those who use random practice could do both blocked and random testing successfully. However, those who only learned blocked practice could only successfully complete the blocked tests. Overall, using random practice as a learning mechanism promotes more learning and the ability to apply these learnings in different contexts. Another key advantage of contextual interference is that random practice leads to better and longer-term learning than blocked practice, which is helpful for overall retention and retrieval. The use of contextual interference has found to be successful across varying domains. For example, in 2007, Roher and Taylor found that using random practice with math problems was more beneficial for performance than grouping them together by problem type, as is currently commonly done in textbooks, for example, all division questions grouped together. Another key example by Colonel and Bjork in 2008 investigated students learning the painting styles of different artists, in which students performed better on the painting memory task when the paintings of artists were presented in a random order rather than grouped by artist. Given contextual interference can be used in diverse contexts, it is advantageous for people trying to learn and practice skills across different domains.